we were talking about Central. Well, Central Catholic was at Clay, and Clay with the ball here in the first quarter. Reese Waymer to, oh, that's Halka.
Oh, big wow. Oh,
the incredible Halka. Takes it down to the 10-yard line, sets up Thomas Clucky. Field goal, 3-0 Eagles on top, but oh, Jace Bowen.
Get him the ball, baby.
Every time he touches it, I feel like he scores.
He gone 63 yards, 7-3 Irish, and then,
Down. Yeah, that's okay. I like that.
Clay down 14-3, and then, that's
just scary. That's Duke scary. Flain scary. Right scary. There. Scary.
Trey Reddick is leveled by Jerron Swain Jr.
Oh.
But as we saw, Reddick would get up, and then seconds later, do that.
And that's right there on the big-time cool. player right there, too, Sean Blue.
Eagles within four at this point. But Troy Durden Scott Jr. to?
Who else?
Oh, Jace Bowen. That's an odd. He's got a lead blocker on that.
You think he's going to score?
Bubba. 70 yards later, he's in the end zone. 21-10 Irish. The second half, Durden Scott Jr. takes it himself. Final score, 42-10 Central. Here's BCSN's Zach Herring.
I believe the tale of two halves here at Clay High School between the Eagles and the Fighting Irish. The Eagles would strike first in the opening quarter with 3 points before a big play from Jace Bowen. After that, mostly Fighting Irish in the second half. Their depth really came to the forefront.
They wore us down at the end. I mean, they scored 2 touchdowns late. You know, that's a great football team over there, that's for sure. So they did. They wore us down a little bit. I mean, our kids kept fighting. But, you know, when you're getting leaned down all game, it takes its toll. We've challenged our kids all year to embrace the challenge. This was a huge challenge for us. Very happy with our effort.
Nothing surprised me. Every year we come out here and play, these guys, they're ready to play. They're ready to go. They're a well-coached football team with tough kids, and that happens every time we come out here. So I wasn't really surprised by anything that happened tonight. You know, that's what you expect out of a young quarterback the more he plays. And seen improvement every week, and that's what we've seen over the last 3 weeks. I think we mixed things up well. I think we got a variety of guys in football. Defensively, I think we're in the right spots, which that's always a key. We just got to make the plays and focus on keep getting better.
The 5-0 Fighting Irish will now take on Whitmer next week in a battle of undefeated teams. Meanwhile, Clay falls to 3-2 and will take on Findlay right here next week. From Clay High School, Zach Herring, Game Day Nation.